Oh, can't get off at four.
Watch out.
It's a rainy day.
Hi guys, welcome back. We're back at Lubbersaw Lakes today. On top pond, I've drawn peg 22. Never fished this peg before, but it's snaggy. There's a lot of snags down here. There's like loads of grass, streamer weeding. You can see it just popping up to the surface. But there's like, I think there's 18 turned up today, so quite a few for here again. I've got two lines out long, well, not long, that 10 metres or so for skimmers, with ground bait, one off to the left for soft pellet and micros. I'm just going to feed that skimmer line again. So not had a, I've had a couple of liners on tip, but I've not had a proper pull yet. But yeah, so it's a funny set, these pegs. This peg's kind of facing like that way, but then chap next to me is terrible pegging today. But it is what it is, I suppose. It would have been better off putting that peg in there. Next one up, 21. Because this peg's the right face and it's efficient same water. I'm just tapping that line back up, so I'm going to go on it in a minute. Either that or I'm going to chuck bomb out with a pop-up on, see if there's any knocking about. It's a lovely day. High pressure though, so I don't think it's going to be hard with how many angles on, but with the amount of the high pressure what's on as well. I think it's going to be a tough day. I'm a bit naffed with pegging though. This peg shouldn't even be in this peg really, won't even have it on most lakes. Terrible cast. That seems to be it. Got nothing ready. It took me ages to get ready. Proper behind. I'm going to feed a few grains of corn into it. Right there. Fish bomb and corn on that line. Yeah, this peg's annoying me. It's like it's set that way, and basically we can basically say water's next peg. But we'll see. I'm gonna go out polling set. Indication then, that's it. Lots of indications. It's no rip. Pull down, Jack. Walk up with a right claggy throat. No, so I've not tried any. I probably should do standard feeder. It's a bit favourite out, but skimmers. Well, that's how we're in. Took us an hour to get set up. It took me ages to plumb up because that stream of weed. Well, it's not a stream of weed, but grass, like a grassy weed. To find a decent spot. Oh, we're in. Oh, we're not in. That's strange. That proper pulled. Shove set waggler on up. I bet waggler would have been alright today. Definitely, I think. Lovely weather. I need to make a decision because I've not put a fish in that yet. My mate Chris Radcliffe, he's turned up for open as well. There's a few turned up. Pardon me. But yeah, so that's how it is. I'm going to turn you that a little bit to make sure you can see what it looks like. Mm-hmm. couple of minutes, if we're not getting enough one, I'm going to have to make a decision about silverfish line for a bit. And catch them skimmers. Yeah, I made that decision. That elastic pulled in. Skimmer straight away. Not a bad size skimmer either. The apples can catch some size. Seems to be like some old and float for me. It was like a bit of an F1 maybe, or a carp. Everything it snagged me up. Not the type of fish I expect to catch on a single pinky. So much weed in that down this margin. I don't think this thing even knows it's up properly yet. See, without it's a foul look, Jeff one. We've got a 7 holo elastic on for that Preston one. Not rushing it, not rushing it. Just one of them small little mirrors. What's in here? Jet propelled. It's a nice looking fish glass. Imagine that, but it's at £30. Right, folks, I'll catch you in a bit. Right, guys, we'll come back. Yeah, so it's 12 o'clock now. We've got a couple of F1s and a small carp and a few skimmers. But it's rock hard. There's loads of snags to my right. It's like, I've been done 3 times on it. Back in this bay bit. It's snaggy as hell, so I've had to come away, but a bit more and replumb a line basically straight up at front, but it's a bit firm. It's proper silty on this side. I just keep feeding little nuggets of ground bait, over wetted, and can't really tell what's coming out. A kid next door to me on my left, he's had a couple of light and some skimmers and that. But nothing on tip yet. I've got bomb and meat out at the minute. I'm just fishing bomb and meat. I'll have a drink. Feel like it's not the right way. It's sticking in, everywhere's soft. I've not found an hard drop anywhere yet. Just like lying out there. It's fishing rock hard. Keep feeding me skim alive. Few pinkies. Need another F1 or so on a car. Nice big car. But yeah, it's I can't really tell what anybody else is catching, so I've not really been concentrating. I had a mare setting up and tripping all that. This weed on my right in this bay, it's like at this point here, it's weedy, kind of ruined right. So I've got to cut it and cut all these trees that way, I'll get in there. But nothing. It seems to be happening. I'm not going to give this much longer. I drink this tea once. I've drunk this tea, it's coming out. What a nice line, inside line. Another. Little indications to keep that in. A chap over me, over to me, on my left, he's got an F1 on. Another good liner then, inside line. I'm gonna leave that another 5 minutes. Have a sandwich, snack attack. Last bit of bread I eat for a while. I decided to enter a bodybuilding show on in August. I've seen that ball of F1s there for corner of that island. What's that? Corner of that island there, look at all them F1s there. You know the side of whale fishing up? Yeah. Look at them all. I've had three F1s and a carp. I keep losing those, like loads of snags it back in here. Proper snaggy down here. Look, man. I don't know what it is. It's like a weed. It's like a... Yeah. See any indications? There's definitely fish held up in that weed in there. There you guys, I'll catch you in a bit. We'll go back on pole now so we can get any more of them skimmers or something to keep winning it net. So I'll catch you in a bit. Alright guys, welcome back. We're into the last hour or so now. This fish rock hard like I'd expected it to, but I think I've got about 12 pound. Maybe a bit more, that's about it. I can't really tell how the moves are getting on. Chap next to me's caught loads of silvers. You catch them shallow as well. So I can't really see how far bank really. I've not took much notice, but yeah. I don't know what they've got down there. Would expect 28. 33 a small archer to be fishing. No, it's been tough. I'm going to get a couple more minutes on this and then go back up pole line and try that. I've had a nightmare, honestly. I've lost five fish. The landing net handle come off, went in. Not my day. I have to dock the float down to so so far down you can barely tell what's going off. Can't really read it, especially with Ripple on. There seems to be fish moving. There does. There's fish definitely moving around about. It's nice and warm. It's been a lovely day. Trying to just fire some pellets, but wind catching them. They're better. It's another 2 minutes on this line and then I'm going to come off it. Lost too many fish to this, like, weedy stuff that's set to me right. Lost one down here. A liner. Wind. Try this pole. I'm gonna try pole line again. That's not a good sign to perch. You barely see the float, but last time you have time to see indications. That wind's picked up, but pushing down. Get my head in these pommies. Try again. I'm just lying. Change rigs. That one's not quitting it, not doing it. Somewhere a bit more stable at wind. An indication then. That's not going to win you out. Try short. It's going to give us a few minutes short. And then probably try this margin. bit of an indication then. Thought that would have gone by now. Not sitting on that. Try another one. Thank you.
happen.
That's one in the bag. Short line. Happy with that. Fuck off.